The pandemic changed a lot about our lives, from the way we work to the way our kids learn. The one trend that the COVID quarantine brought us, an increase in homeschooled children.
And it's a trend that seems to be sticking around. Investigative reporter Julie Millay joins us with a look at the changing education landscape. Julie?
Tom, many parents turned to homeschooling during the pandemic in favor of virtual classrooms, and the numbers show a lot of them aren't going back.
Has to be history. I like learning about things from a very long time ago.
Miles Healy and his sister Blythe love to learn at home.
I think it's really, like, really fun, like, get to sit on the couch and just read.
Well, there's more to it than that.
Was he a fire-spewing dragon?
Yes, he was.
Miles and Blythe's mom, Elizabeth Healy, has been homeschooling her kids for about 2 years. The decision to do so was a product of the pandemic.
I'm really, really worried that that reading over Zoom or Google Classroom or inconsistency between the two was just going to hinder her learning, and we were going to have a ton of learning loss.
And because her students had already started virtual learning during quarantine,
it didn't seem like such a big jump into the unknown.
Once they got going, the Healy family found the homeschool model worked well for them.
It does give us some flexibility. So we have flexibility in starts and stop time.
Did parents try this during COVID and then go, oh, I could do this?
Yes, that is exactly it.
Ann Miller is the president of HEAVE. That's the Homeschool Educators of Virginia. She tells us a sky-high number of parents who chose to homeschool their kids due to the pandemic discovered its benefits and stuck with it.
I mean, that year, our office, we dealt with over 90,000 calls.
We took a look at the numbers. According to the Virginia Department of Education, the number of families choosing to homeschool in Virginia Beach just about doubled from 2019 to 2020. While the numbers dipped a bit in 2021, it's still up 70% from pre-pandemic levels.
This one-on-one individualized instruction, which every teacher will tell you that's like the dream.
You're just dealing with your two. You can move really fast, and you can also really slow down when you need to slow down.
The upward trend exists at several districts in Hampton Roads.
They saw their kids were much calmer. I'm going to cry, because I can't tell you how many stories we've heard from parents who said, I got my child back.
Miller says with several highly publicized school shootings in recent years, security at school is another reason parents may choose to keep their kids at home.
And when those kinds of things happen, we have a lot of parents call. And there's all the issues of bullying. And I know the schools are doing everything they can, but it's hard.
Elizabeth Healy says safety for her kids wasn't a concern for her family, nor was the quality of the school district.
It was just the limbo that we were in because of COVID.
And that homeschooling is not without its drawbacks.
The cons are, it's on you. You know, I feel like that can be a heavy burden.
The Healys tell me homeschooling might not be forever for them, and they are open to returning to the classroom in the future. If you'd like more information on homeschooling your kids, check out our website. For now, I'm Julie Millay, 10 on your side.